This is Karan Shah. So I recently graduated from Nirma Institute. I am an engineer. I did my BTech in computer engineering. So right now I've joined IIM Kolkata and I'm talking to you guys from the campus. So I converted IIM Kolkata, IIM Lucknow, IIM Kozhikode, Shillong and all the other major B schools. So talking about my journey, I'll start section by section. So as an engineer, a lot of people will relate with my preparation because I was very weak in verbal section and I knew that I had to put a lot of efforts, particularly for VS section. So when I started attempting my mocks, I used to score 50 to 70 percentile, and I ended up scoring 99.48% in verbal. So the preparation was not easy, but I would say, firstly, I want to clear that CAT is not an IQ or talent exam. Like, it is more about how you prepare and it is more of a strategy exam. So even if you don't have any pretty decent ACATs, or you are not brilliant in quant or let's say verbal, or you don't have a very good vocabulary, or you might feel that you don't speak up to the level a lot of other people speak, it's not about that. It's just preparing in a phased manner and it's going, basically sticking to your own strategy. So for verbal, what I used to do is daily solve 4 to 5 RCs every day. And for quant and LRDI, since I was an engineer and I knew that I was good at quant and LRDI, you don't take it for granted, you solve regularly. But let's say I used to dedicate some more time to verbal. But the strategy a lot of people would do is that they'll completely do verbal for one day and then they'll do quant for another day and then LRDI for another day. What better strategy is you solve each and every section every day. Like you practice verbal, quant, LRDI every day. And basically, there might be one more concern among engineers that right now they must be in their third year or final year and they must be confused that should they go for placements or like for keeping it as a backup or rather they should focus their entire time on CAT. I was going through the same dilemma, but what I discovered for myself is that even if I get a placement, will I take that placement or will I take a drop and appear for CAT next year? So what I figured out is that I'll give CAT only because I didn't want to get in the technical background. So I didn't appear for placements till my CAT got over. So in Nirma, all companies kept coming even after CAT examination, and then I set for the placement and luckily I even got a placement. But during my CAT preparation, I was very clear. I was not even applying in any company and I was giving my entire time to CAT. And a lot of you might be feeling that your profile is not up to the mark and you might want to participate in various competitions, various case study competitions, and you want to make your CV look better. I would suggest that don't do that right now. Even if you don't have anything on your profile, just focus your time on CAT. Because CAT is a prerequisite. If you don't score well in CAT, you won't even get a chance to make a resume or let's say fill the profile form. So focus your entire time on CAT, and there is enough time after CAT to start with your GDPI preparation. What right now regarding GDPI preparation you can do is just keep updated with all the current affairs. So guys, first of all, as I said that I was not very good at BRC, and this is the particular section where I devoted my maximum efforts. So for me, what worked for me was I used to solve 4 to 5 RCs every day. I tried to improve my accuracy. So like when I started, I used to score, let's say if there are 5 questions, I'll get 1 or 2 correct. But then if there are 3 questions wrong, then I need to see that what went wrong. Like there can be n number of issues, like you didn't understand the paragraph, or maybe while you were reading the paragraph with less concentration, or when you were attempting the question, you figured out wrong that you understood the question in a wrong manner, or the options were quite confusing. This options confusion is the worst problem that we all will face while solving. Like there will be at times there will be three options that you think that, okay, this can be an answer, this can be an answer, this can be an answer. But then you need to figure out from the author's point of view, what author might be thinking, what author is trying to say in that particular paragraph. So while reading an RC, what you should do is, when you are reading one paragraph, after that, take 5 or 10 seconds and understand that what is the one line summary of that particular paragraph. Then go to the next paragraph, then go to the third paragraph. Now you must be thinking that itna to time hi nahi hai. In CAT paper, in CAT, like you know, in a 40 minute section, you don't have so much time. But this happens intuitive. Like when you are practicing, keep in mind that you have to take 10 seconds and when you will when you will practice this every day, you will see improvement and then you will find that, okay, while you are reading the paragraph, a summary point is being made in your mind itself. And that helps because you after reading an entire passage, you have 4 summary points and you have the gist of the entire paragraph. Then while attempting the question, you don't need to go to the paragraph again. So read the passage at your own pace. Like a lot of people will read a passage in like 2 minutes and then devote more time on particular question. But a right strategy or something that worked for me was, I used to give 3 to 4 minutes to an entire passage. I'll read at my own pace, not go fast or not go slow. I'll read at my own passage and I used to take 3 to 4 minutes to read the passage and then not give more than 1 minute to an entire question. So this is a particular strategy that worked for me in RCs. And for VA section, I used to attempt in the order of, like, I used to attempt summary questions first, then odd one out, and then para-jumbles, because para-jumbles are the question where you, like, where there are maximum chance that you will get it wrong. So first of all, I used to attempt a summary and then odd one out, and first just fix your order and keep doing it regularly. Like, fix your own strategy. Don't change your strategy every day. Like, let's say in this, like, you can definitely experiment in starting 4 to 5 mocks, but then if one thing starts working for you, then just keep doing it regularly and you should go through. Like, and also I didn't have any, like, I had not read any single book in my entire life before I started my preparation for CAT. But in those 11 months of preparation, I had read almost 20 to 25 books. And there is no fix. Like, a lot of students will ask that what type of genre we should read. There is nothing such. If you don't like to read books, read newspaper, read an editorial. There are a lot of editorials available online. Even Endeavor have a particular section where they, you know, create an editorial and keep it on the portal, and you can attempt it in the way of RC. So basically, you are practicing your RC, your RC preparation is going on, as well as you are getting updated with the current affairs. You should make the maximum use of the editorial section, I would say. And yeah, rest all, just keep doing. And I know verbal, the main problem is the accuracy, but you should understand that what you're doing wrong and just keep adding on to it.